That's a tune called Lady on the Island. And normally I would play it on a chromatic harmonica, because I think that its solo tune suits it. And most of my playing is on chromatic. But I love the diatonic harmonica. I've been playing it for years as well. But I got a harmonica from Easttop, Harmonica, Easttop Harmonica Company, and Brendan Power today. And it's solo tune D, Lucky 13, these extended range harmonicas. And they've got a plethora of them for sale at the moment. Standard Lucky 13, which is the Richter. Got it in all 12 keys. Paddy Richter, Power Jaw, Power Bender, solo tune like I'm playing, Power Chromatic, and the diminished Lucky 13. Now, they're really nice harmonica. As I say, it came today. I've been playing a little bit on it and trying to get used to it, but it's super harmonica. Now, what I like about it is it's got this low A, the fifth of D. It's got an extra note down the end here. This is solo tuning, so it starts on an A, a low A below the D. Now that was a B part of the first tune that I played there, Lady on the Island. I can switch for contrast and play the B parts on the bottom end of it. So it's really nice while the fiddle or some other instrument is playing high, I can play the B parts on the lower octave. I really like it because it centers me a lot better. I know where I'm playing, and to play that tune on a chromatic, I would have to play it in the second octave to allow myself to get down to that A. So it means I have to position myself in the middle, whereas here it's more, it feels better on a diatonic harmonica to be on the bottom end of it, you know. So I really like that. Now, I was trying to think of other tunes as well. There's one called The Lark in the Morning. It's a jig, and it's got one of those low A's as well. So really nice, strong notes, half valved. All the draw notes are valved. Now, one modification I made, because I took it apart this morning to have a look at it. It's a beautiful harmonica, really nicely designed. It's got nice volume. And the one thing I did find was, excuse me, a few years ago, I tuned a few harmonicas to solo tuning, a couple of diatonics to solo tuning. And I found that the sevenths, the C sharp, say on a D, because of the solo tuning, were a little weaker. So usually what I would do straight away is I would valve the blow note on hole two, and the same for any other C sharps, I would valve the blow note. So then I've got the blow and the draw valve on that hole, and it makes for a lot stronger performance from it. Now, it's, as I say, really nice harmonica. I'm going to play it a lot more, especially in some of the fiddle sets with when myself and Josephine are playing, because I love diatonic harmonica. Now, there are, of course, some great diatonic players out there, like Rick Brendan himself and Joel Anderson, and they use different tunings to accommodate playing traditional music. But I always like the solo, and I've got a couple of octave tuned solo tuned octave harmonicas. But say a G will always start on a G and a D will start on a D. I don't have that low note below it. This has it, and it makes for easy playing. Now, it's also useful for blues and stuff like that. You can play in a kind of minor position that you would on a chromatic, like George Smith. And because of the vowels, you can bend a lot of the notes. It's a really nice harmonica. I would love to try the G and the C as well, but the D is really nice. And I love the range. So, just another really nice product by Brendan and the Easttop Company. So, for any of you out there that play in solo tuning but would love the diatonic sound, I think this is a perfect instrument. All right, happy harping.